Second place, was it?
Second runner-up.
And going over to South Africa and winning with Africa is just remarkable. And to see the transformation from participating in Miss Ghana and what you have become now. I think that, Ina, you deserve a big round of applause for what you've done. Yes, and your team, of course.
Media, everyone.
Right. Well, it's an honor to be able to support you. That's what the ministry was set up to do. On my part, I think that having grown up in this industry and not having a place that we could call our own ministry, and today having a ministry, I'm just so empowered and so motivated to do the best that I can to support people like you. Private people who are doing well in their own space and trying to create a platform for young women, young men to become whatever they want to be. Yeah. And you've changed my perception about beauty pageants, actually.
Oh, we have
got. I used to think that it was all about looks. But listening to the questions and the way the participants answer them, I think that is also intellectually stimulating. And for her to have performed so brilliantly and subsequently won the ultimate prize is beauty and brains working together. So tell me a bit about your experience.
Honestly, it wasn't easy because I came across amazing, beautiful African ladies who were also willing to make their countries fit. But Africa, Ghana, we always say is the gateway to Africa.
Right.
And I cannot go for the competition and I love someone but take me. So I worked hard, I was committed, and I was just looking up to God, and He made it come true. So I'm very humble to everybody, each and everyone who supported. Ghanaians have been amazing. They voted so well for
me. Oh, good.
Yeah,
good, so I'm really grateful.
And thank you so much.
Good. It's an honor. Stop thanking me. We thank His Excellency President John Dramani Mahama for putting me there.
Thank you.
So Ina, the whole experience.
It was our first, event in the center. It's the maiden Miss Africa continent.
Oh, it's the first time?
It is.
Ah.
It is. And it was quite challenging because the organizers didn't give you a clear-cut idea of what the judging criteria would be. But we just applied ourselves from various experiences and other functions, such as participating in the world. And we said that you must have an open mind and be ready for anything. And amazingly, it's like you give up hope.
Yeah.
I mean, you should have seen us in the audience cheering here on.
Yes,
when I mean, it started with eviction. There were 40 countries, and they shot.
Oh no, that big for
yes,
the first event.
Yes, and they shortlisted it to 12. So after the first cut of point, she called and she was so speaking as English. She said, "In the language again, maybe a cry." You know, so she really pushed and she got to
your attention, please.
And then on the final
EgyptAir flight MS-881
from
Cairo has just landed.
First question, make or break question goes to Ghana.
Flight MS-881
usually when it's like your first question,
there's
no attention and anything could go wrong. And a question just like it is like a pop. I was sitting in my seat and she delivered. The audience cheered her on because remember there were representatives from South Africa, Zambia, yeah, and so you'd imagine the audience was South African. When she talked about empowering the youth, you should have seen them because you realize that a lot of times most of the youth don't believe in themselves. So she talked about it, you should have seen the audience and the goosebumps. I mean, tears of joy. We were so happy. Then there was a steam harbour. when they were going to announce us, the winners, they started from the first princess and they said Ghana. I was very disappointed because I had observed, I knew my girl was winning, you know?
Yeah.
And when they said, you know, third position, I thought, okay, don't be a sore loser. I got up with my family. Then the hostess,
save your face.
The hostess was like, no, I think I put a sweat. You know, and I just sat up and then they said, oh, made a mistake. So we said the judges now. Then they made another error with the second one.
Oh my goodness.
And they said, okay, then the last become, hey, you should have seen. So it was
it was a heavenly moment.
Absolutely. And we're really grateful
yes.
for the support from the team, from especially media, because you know, coming from, should I say, another African country,
right.
The weight you have, the support you have from your country,
yes.
media pushing
yes.
you
yes.
gives you a foot in the door, you know? So it really, really helps us as well. And coupled with, of course, not
forgetting because
this attention. Whole thing started from...
We love passengers traveling Alaska Airlines flight KP-021 to Lomé. Please complete departure formalities and proceed to boarding gate 1B.
But hey, this
passengers of flight
KP-021
to Lomé, please proceed to boarding gate 1B. Thank you.
But I'm surprised at the number of media personnel who are here on behalf of the team, the exclusive team, and the newest queen in the country. I want to thank the media for honoring them by your presence here. And let's go make Ghana proud. Let's go celebrate what we have. It's a beautiful pageant, but like I said, I have a change of mind now. Because I see now that it's not only about physical looks but also intellectual ability to answer questions on the spot, questions that you don't get opportunity to see before they are given to you, and to be able to answer them so convincingly and win. It means that the pageant is really about making a total package of spirit, body and soul and mind. And so let's all celebrate her the best way we can. So that going forward, the other two contestants who are also, I think they're gearing up for another event.
Miss World and Miss Worlds,
that they would also be inspired and motivated to go and give
their big sisters challenge them.
Yes, absolutely, absolutely. And at the moment that you're standing there, when Ghana, you are Ghana at that moment, it's not even His Excellency, it's not the First Lady, it's not the Vice President, it's not the Second Lady. It's you at that moment as Ghana, and that should make you feel proud that you've been able to win this among the African countries that was there. You represented our country very well, and I applaud you and celebrate you this morning. Thank you very much, everybody.